Hi, this is SHARE S20, a LiDAR scanner from SHARE UAV. I have already made the first review of this 3D scanner, but in this video, I'm going to test it on a mountain in a very remote area of Thailand. Yeah, this is my survey grade RTK GPS receiver, costs around $5,000-$6,000. This GPS receiver can receive about 33 to 38 satellites, but the antenna from the S20, it reports on a display that it pick up 50 satellites, and sometimes when I went up to the mountaintop, I can receive like 55 satellites from this antenna, which is quite a lot for a RTK GPS receiver. Okay, I'm not an RTK expert, but let me explain a little bit in case that you don't know how it works. So the GPS receiver will receive multiple signals from the satellites. The signal went through atmosphere, so it's going to throw a lot of error. Usually you will get up to 3 meters to 10 meters of the error to correct the error by using another GPS receiver, but this time they put it up on a fixed tripod. It's going to throw the same error because it's in the not far away from the first receiver. To correct the error value, they place this second GPS receiver on a known coordinate. If this one going to the right for 3 meters, it's going to send a radio signal to tell this, we call this one rover, and we call this one base station. So the base will send correct data to the lower. This error will be corrected, and you will get a very small error, up to plus or minus 8 millimeter in the horizontal, or 15 millimeter in the vertical. So if you own a SHARE S20, it's not going to be convenient to carry a base station, and you need to put it on a known coordinate. You need to find a pin, the land pin that has the coordinate to send the correction data to your LiDAR scanner. And trip service provider in Thailand is run by the government. They put this base station and then they connect it to their server. We have like 200 or 300 of the base station all over the country. So the base station is set up in a triangle layout. So each triangle is like 40 to 60 kilometers. So it's quite far. And if I place my GPS receiver inside the triangle, the base station is be too far. Coarse network. It's going to create a virtual base station by using the information from the real base station. So you can't see this, and usually it will space like 8 to 15 meters away from the lower. This virtual base station is going to send the correct data using the mobile data, 4G or 5G. So it will collect at the rate of 2 Hz. So every 1 second, it's going to send 2 of the correction data. Core network is very expensive. For the large network like this, it requires maintenance. You need to connect each base station to the server, so it's very expensive to maintain. Only government can run this, and it costs like 15 to 20 million US dollar to build this network. The green one is the one that is working, and the red one is the one that is down. So sometimes they have a network down, maybe from the internet connection or power outage. SHARE S20 connect to the phone by using Bluetooth and Wi-Fi 6, and I found that the connection is very fast and reliable, same as the chassis one. The RTK is showing single status. It means that collection data has not been sent to the phone yet. And it only takes 8 seconds from single to fix. This time of the year is Blossom Festival in the northern Thailand. And this is the tea plantation, 1,500 meters from the sea level. When I click on the letter RTK, it's going to display the coordinates and number of satellite. Now I'm going to enter the indoor area, and it will lose the signal for a momentary, and it will reconnect automatically when I walk out. Now I'm going to start a second scan. The first scan and the second scan has GPS coordinates, so it will align itself automatically. And this scan, I'm not going back for closing the loop. I'll just stop at the end of the road here. So the precision of the scan will rely purely on the RTK. 124 meters of the travel in under 3 minutes. So when your scan data have a fixed solution, it will allow you to enable this RTK fusion. And then you can choose the coordinate system. They have a series of the coordinate system database. What I'm using here is WGS84, and the zone that I'm using is 47N. I'm in the west side of Thailand. If I'm in the east side of Thailand, I'm going to use the 48N. And the rest of the setting is the same. Dynamic object filtering, point cloud colorization. The control point is not enabled when you select the RTK fusion. Then you can click on start the calculation for processing. Okay, this will be the result from the tea plantation scan. This point cloud is fused by using the RTK. When I click on the point cloud here, it's going to show GPS coordinates. So the C is 1,442. This will be the epsilon height of the ground. And if I click on save, it's going to save the measurement coordinates here. And you can use the copy command to copy each point from the scan data. It's going to contain the GPS coordinate. So if I want to know what is the height, so the measuring tool has a dot line that you can see the alignment. Now it's 38 meters for the SHARE S20 and the C1. Color point cloud can go up to 40 meters, but the non-color version is go even further. 60 sometime I can detect 70 meters, but the color one will go up to 40 meters. If I click on save, you can read the delta C value. It's say 4.493 meters. Okay, this will be the second scan. The first scan and the second scan, it align itself automatically because it contains a GPS coordinate. So if you are going to scan a very large landscape, you can split the scan into the multiple scan, and it will align itself with the GPS coordinate. And the processing time for this scan is about an hour. It's no complaint about the performance of the report. What you see here is a 4K resolution. You can use it for construction planning. So the orientation of the scan data, the y-axis will be the north and the x-axis will be the east. Okay, so this will be the scanning result from the S20. Detail on the stone wall is quite good, but as I said before, the quality of the point cloud from the RTK is not as good as the SLAM. But in this open field like this, SLAM is not going to work very well. There's no feature to track, just empty field with some trees. RTK would be benefit. If I use SLAM to scan, it would take twice the time. The load here looks so real. I mean, I don't even need to use the 3DGS. The detail from the color point cloud is quite good. Let's move to the second project. Okay, this will be the second test. I was still up on the mountain, and I'm going to make a 2 long travel distance scan. The first one will be a 570 meters long, which took me about 11 minutes to scan. There are some trees that can block the GPS signal, but the SHARE S20 can manage to get more than like 95% of the fixed solution. And when I was scanning this, I had a very slow internet connection. In the second scan, I was stuck under the dense tree, so I only have a float solution. Float solution will give 60 centimeter to 1 meter of the accuracy alert. When I picked this up, it turned into a fixed solution. The software will only use a fixed solution for calculating for the trajectory. If it's float solution, it's going to switch to a IMU sensor. Okay, the girls are my daughter. Travel distance in this scan is 790 meters in 11 minutes. Okay, let's take a look at the result. This will be the first scan, 570 meters. I think I start here and end here, and no loop back. And this will be from the second scan. You can see that the first scan and second scan, it align itself automatically. So you can simply use the S20 for map making. So it's going to take longer time than using the drone, but you have a better accuracy. And you can see the edge of the load much clearer than the drones. See a traffic mark, speed bump, it's all there. Comparing with the drones, you can erase the trees and get a clear view of the load for map making. And you can split the scan in the multiple scan. With the RTK, it's going to align itself. You don't have to do the loop back. You can travel twice as long. Comparing with the SLAM, I didn't turn on the dynamic object removal, so the moving object like people, they are still all there. I forgot to turn it on. Okay, this area is quite dense, the trees, especially when I start the second scan here. I think I started here under this tree, so the tree is surrounding the GPS signal when I put it on the ground, but when I pick it up, it reconnect to the GPS signal. You need to wait for a while. Let me turn off one of the scan data because there's too many and my PC is slowing down, but software is still smooth. Okay, let's see here. Yeah, I can read this. The sign is quite clear. If you are Thai, you can read this. I'm not going to translate this to you, but I can tell that the quality of the point cloud from the SLAM will be better than the RTK. But in this case, you have no choice. The quality of the scan will be depends on your reception of the RTK and also your internet connection and trip network provider. It's many factors. Okay, actually the detail is higher. You need to wait for the computer to display. Okay, this will be the second scan. Let's move faster. But if I stop, it's going to show more details. It's quite long distance. Okay, I make a turn here. I make a turn here. Oh, it's not bad, right? Look at the car here. It's from the RTK. I just walked past this only one time and it's quite good. Okay, let's check here. The security box. I think it's look okay. Quality of scan is okay. See the red and white on the sidewalk. Quite clear. This would be the toilet. Yeah, toilet building is, yeah, it's clear. Information is clear. Okay, this will be the market area. It's open area with some trees. Okay, the sign here is really clear. I can't read this. If I click on the measurement, click on here, click on save. Click on go to. Okay, yes, the map was taken in the dry season, I guess. This will be the place where I parked the car. This will be the market. Yeah, the lot is aligned in the same orientation. This and this, yeah, let's give a true north on the map. Okay, so here's my review on the SHARE S20 RTK functionality. It's worked quite well, no error, no hiccup. Connection is very good and it's quite reliable for using as a survey equipment. So the next video will be the review of the S20 with the SLAM algorithm, tracking a narrow corridors and also a larger building. Okay, thanks you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next video.